Hello, welcome to our channel.
We got a lot of questions about our television and satellite setup. In this episode, we are going to try to explain to you or show to you how things work. So, come along.
Television.
Yeah. Television.
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 Satellite TV in a converter transporter van. Is that realistic? Can it be done? We've tried it, found some practical solutions, and even a little van life hack. So, we think we found the best solution for us.
Since our van is not too big, we need to store everything in the back of the van. So the television is there and also the satellite. The satellite receiver is not on the roof. The television is here in a bag, and the satellite receiver, I already took it out, is here in this box. So first, let's start with the television. Normally, we position our television at the front seat, at the passenger seat. And we use this device for that. It is a device we found on the internet after a long search. And I will leave the link in the description below. And what you can see here is what it is. It's a plate on a device that can wiggle or that can move around. And it's connected to the headrest of the chair. It's like that. So what you can do with this, because the connecting plate, the back of this is connected to the television, I'll show you in a minute. So you can position the television here. It's a flexible way of doing that. We keep the television in the back. So we take it out. And then I can easily show you the back of the television and the plate that holds the television to the chair. So let's connect it. Easy. That's step one. You can still maneuver everything around if you need. Next, we have the cable for the signal to go to the television. And the other end goes into the box. There's two positions and we use the STB position for that. Next up, electricity. This is the connector for the cigarette lighter. And we have purpose-made cigarette lighter connectors for that. So, and there it goes. And this is the connection that goes into the television. Easy. And then we have the connectors for the electricity for the antenna box. So this goes into the box and this is for into the cigarette lighter. Purpose made.
And now for the satellite receiver.
Box is a great place to place the satellite receiver on. It needs to be more or less stable because this is going to turn. Good. The task now is to connect the cables. There's two cables. One needs to be connected, the other one needs to be connected to the box. Let's do that. This is the cable for the data that we are going to connect to the back of the receiver. And then everything that we do depends on the position where we can put the receiver. We needed to put it here because of the direction of the satellite. But follow this cable. What we do, we put it on the outside and then it comes back here. And the same for the control and power cable. It is already fixed on the machine, so you don't need to connect it. You only need to connect it to the box. We are also going to lead it like that. What I usually like to do with this cable is to have this connection point covered in some way. Now it is covered here, sheltered from the rain. The other thing, we need to lead the cables inside. But the problem is that the cables get damaged if you do it wrong. We need to find a way to do it properly. Like this seems to be the right position. If we now close the door, the cable does not get damaged. Check. Then we connect the second data cable. This one is connected to the satellite receiver. And then we connect the antenna unit. So here this is the power and the automation that goes through this cable. It's also connected to the satellite receiver. And now everything should be fine. So we can start up the system. You've seen the satellite. The satellite was just in a resting position. We are now going to press the power button. It's blinking orange, OSTRA 3. Then you just press the set button. And then we'll have a look outside what's happening. Here, the red home is going on. And the satellite is now going up. Satellite receiver is going up. It has its own GPS and things like that inside, so you don't need to do anything. So when it has found where it is, it will turn green instead of red. And when it has actually locked in place with the satellite, it will stop flashing and it will burn continuously in green. Green light, everything on, and then turn on the television.
Perfect. We think it showed. For us, this was the best flexible satellite solution. And we hope it helped you as well. And in the case that you still have any questions, please let us know in the comments below. If we can, we will happily answer any of your questions. And with that, we've come to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. We hope you like this video. If you did like this video, please consider subscribing. And if you are already subscribed, we would like to thank you very much for your support. In any way, we hope to see you next time for our next video. So, until then, bye bye.